Now, on average, Australian drivers spend two entire weeks of their lives waiting for traffic lights to change.
So, is there a way to get a green light quicker, or is it all just a matter of timing? Today's Jessica Millwood decided to investigate.
We spend hours waiting at them every year, but do we really know how traffic lights tick?
You know how exactly traffic lights work?
Sort of.
Well, red, green and orange.
We took a ride with the RACQ to get to the bottom of myths surrounding lights. First, is there a way to turn a light green faster? Well, the answer is yes, but it's all dependent on the driver stopping in the right spot on top of sensors or loops located just before the white line.
Because if the sensor can't see a car there, it won't trigger the green, because it cannot see any traffic.
In which case, it would eventually have to turn green though, wouldn't it? It'd just take longer.
Well, in the quieter times, certainly in those off-peak times, it may stay red for a long time.
And rolling forward won't change the light any faster.
The further you edge forward, the further you move away from the sensor, and the sensor simply doesn't know you are there. It assumes you have gone.
Next question, will the light stay green if there are a lot of cars waiting? Again, this depends on the position of your car.
It's important to stay reasonably close to the car in front. That way, the signals can not just read that there is a vehicle waiting to turn right, but also as the line of traffic starts to move, it can see that there is a number of vehicles that are turning right, and it can hold that signal for slightly longer.
Is there a set amount of time lights stay green or red? Well, to answer this, we take you inside Sydney's Transport Management Centre, where all lights are monitored around the clock.
So the way our traffic lights work here in Sydney is that they're actually adaptive, which means the system's constantly measuring the amount of traffic and the density of traffic and adjusting the time that the green light's shown depending on what the traffic demand is at any particular location.
However, as a rule, you'll never have to wait at a red for longer than 2.5 minutes. Myth 4, pressing the button at pedestrian crossings multiple times makes it change quicker.
A lot of people, and I'm guilty of doing this sometimes, think if you bang it more than once, it'll go green quicker. Oh, that was good.
Once or many, it makes no difference. Just press the button once and the timer will then start going through that process. By pressing it many times, it makes no difference.
And finally, can you complain if you think a light is broken?
If you know there is a problem with a set of traffic lights at an intersection, or it's changed the way that it's gone through its sequence of lights, then report that and have someone look at it, because you may well be saving a lot of other motorists from frustration.
I am sure the red light goes for longer than 2.5 minutes. Oh,
It feels like it, doesn't it? Yeah. It's a good topic to discuss, and I'm sure that you've had experiences too. If you've got issues with your traffic lights in your local area and you believe that they are not working correctly, though, you can always contact the Department of Main Roads in your state and get them on the case.
Yeah. Don't contact us. Contact Main Roads.
Yeah. Maybe they'll help you out. We won't.